Extreme weather events are now more frequent and severe than ever. Floods, fires, heat waves, or cold snaps get a lot of media attention, and climate scientists are starting to make increasingly direct and public statements about the risks for society. But the science behind what we're seeing now has been known for 200 years. Do you want to know how climate change was discovered? Joseph Fourier, a French mathematician, was so fascinated by the equations governing heat transfer that he decided to calculate how much energy from the sun hit our planet. The result was not what he expected. His calculations showed that the Earth ought to be much colder than it was. Something in the atmosphere was preventing heat from escaping. But what could it be? He never got to know the answer. It took three decades until another scientist, Eunice Newton Foote, became intrigued by the possibility that the atmosphere could be trapping heat. She devised an experiment. Several glass cylinders equipped with thermometers and filled with different gases. She put the cylinders in the sun to heat up, later moving them to the shade to cool down, proving that carbon dioxide retained heat much longer than other gases. With a published paper and convinced that what happened inside the cylinders could also happen to our planet, Foote faced barriers to presenting her work, and her discoveries never received the attention they deserved. 3 years later, the climate science spotlight fell on the Irish scientist John Tyndall. Sharing the scientific concerns of his time, Tyndall thought changes in the atmosphere had caused the ice ages. To investigate, he designed precise equipment and tested different gases. Much like Foote, Tyndall found that CO2 retained the most heat, exactly 1,000 times as much heat as dry air. The consequences of tiny increases in the amounts of CO2 worried him, but it did not trouble others. Born the same year, Tyndall published his results. Swedish mathematician Svante Arrhenius ended up studying both Fourier's and Tyndall's findings. To put the pieces together, Arrhenius calculated, by hand, how much CO2 it would take to alter global temperatures. He saw that if the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere were to double, the Earth's temperature would rise by a drastic 5 to 6 degrees Celsius. But even though he described the greenhouse effect, he was not concerned. In fact, he predicted it would take 3,000 years for CO2 levels to rise by 50%, causing climate change. Today, we have reasons for concern, because it doesn't matter when we discovered climate change. The science is clear. It's been clear for a long time. How long will it take for us to listen to it?